So now we'll take next question. Question number 8, India's 28 and India's 110. The question has been given based on control definition. So you should remember what is the control definition. So let us read the question, then I will give an idea of control definition in a brief. Angel Limited has adopted Ind AS with a transition date on 1st April 2017. So they have adopted Ind AS with a transition date 1st April 2017. Prior to Ind AS adoption, if followed accounting standard notified under Companies Accounting Standard Rule 2006, means before the Ind AS they were following accounting standard in simple word. It has made investment in equity shares of Pharma Limited, a listed company engaged in the business of pharmaceuticals. The shareholders pattern of Pharma Limited is given below. The shareholding pattern of Pharma Limited, Angel Limited hold 21%, Little Angel Limited 24%, then Wealth Master Mutual Fund 3%, and individual public shareholders, means there were many public shareholders holding 52%. So from this point of view, from the point of AS, can I say Angel Limited is an investor, and for them this Pharma Limited become associate, means as per it was an associate. Pharma Limited was an associate. More than 20% they are holding. Correct now? Understood? Now what is note number 2 that also we need to understand? They have given for Little Angel Limited. Now none of the shareholders have entered into any shareholders agreement. Means this they were not under any shareholders agreement. Okay? Little Angel Limited is a subsidiary of Angel Limited in which Angel Limited hold 51% voting power. So Little Limited is a subsidiary of Little Angel Limited is a subsidiary of Angel Limited. So this company is what? This Little Angel Limited is a subsidiary of Angel Limited. So okay, both together are also not holding more than 50%. Therefore, once again, as per accounting standard, so it is not a subsidiary. Pharma is not a subsidiary, correct? Wealth Master Mutual Fund is not related party of either Little Angel Limited or Pharma Limited. So they are not under any relationship. Individual public shareholders represent 17,455 individual. None of the individual shareholders hold more than 1% of voting in Pharma Limited. Means they cannot also acquire control. All commercial decision of Pharma Limited are taken by its director, who are appointed by a simple majority vote of shareholders in the annual general meeting. The following table shows the voting pattern of past AGM of Pharma Limited. So all commercial decisions were taken by director who are appointed by a simple majority voting. So now they have given 13, 14, 14, 15, 15, 16 a pattern. Angel Limited attended and voted in favor of resolution. In all cases they have written means Angel Limited will always come in AGM and they will vote in favor of resolution. Little Angel Limited attended and voted as per the decision of what? Angel Limited. Wealth Master Mutual Fund attended and voted in favor of all resolution, means they have also given consent to all resolution except for reappointment of retiring directors. Means there is some retiring directors, they are not favor in that case. Individuals, is sab mein wahi likha hua hai, individuals. 7% of individual shareholders attended the AGM. All the individual shareholders vote in favor of all the resolution, except that 50% of individual shareholders voted against the resolution to appoint retiring directors. Means only 7% are attending annual general meeting. Theek hai na? Then next year 8%, the next year 6%. Pharma Limited has obtained a substantial long-term borrowing from a bank. The loan is payable in 20 years from 1st April 2017. As per terms of borrowing, following action of by Pharma Limited will require prior approval from bank. So bank are always given some protective right, payment of dividend to shareholders in cash or kind, buyback of his own equity shares, issue of bonus equity shares, amalgamation of Pharma Limited, obtaining additional loan from any other entity. Okay? Recently the board of directors of Pharma Limited proposed a dividend of 5 per share. However, when CFO of Pharma Limited approached the bank for obtaining their approval, the bank rejected a proposal citing concern over the short-term cash liquidity of Pharma Limited. His bank says, no, you are not supposed to pay 5 rupees per share. Having learned about the development, the directors of Angel Limited, along with the directors of Little Angel Limited, approached the bank with a request to reconsider its decision. The directors of Angel Limited and Little Angel Limited asked the bank to approve and reduce the dividend at least to 2 per share. However, the bank categorically refused to approve any payout of dividend. They once again said no dividend will be paid. Under IGAAP, Angel Limited is classified Pharma Limited as an associate, means as per accounting standard. As the CFO of Angel Limited, you are required to comment the correct classification of Pharma on transition to Ind AS. Means as per Ind AS, it will be an associate or subsidiary that we need to understand. For that, we need to understand the meaning of control. Now, we are doing which question? Question number 8, based on Ind AS 110 and Ind AS 28. Ind AS 28. Ind AS 28 is for investment in associate or joint venture. Now, what Ind AS 110 says? See, control have 3 elements. Means any investor will control any investee when they have 3 elements. First is what? Power over investee. Second is what? They must have exposure to or right to variable return through its involvement in investee. And third is what? There must be ability to use power. Power means what? Ki investor must have existing right which gives current ability to direct relevant activities of investee. Existing right, they said, should be substantive right. Should not be protective right. You see, protective right is given that will not give any power. For example, in this case, bank has given some protective right, but that right will not be considered for power over investee. So should not be protective right. The substantive right may be acquired. If they are holding more than 50% of voting power, may arise. Means substantive right means what? Practical ability to exercise right. It means practical ability to exercise a right. Means even though if they are holding more than 50%, but if they are not able to exercise their right, then they will have no power. This right might be also acquired through contractual agreement with other vote holder. This may be also acquired due to widely dispersed shareholding. So in this case, you can see 52% was held by public, which were widely dispersed, and they were not actively participating in what? Annual general meeting, correct? And due to what? Potential voting right also. So there might be some potential voting right. So because of potential voting right, they might have some current ability to exercise what? To direct relevant activities. This is the meaning of what? Power. If there is a power over investee and there is exposure to a right to variable return, and also ability to use power, then we say investor has what? Control over investee. Are we reading? Now let us see the answer. So of course from the question it understood ki the angel limited with little angel limited is able to what? Control pharma limited. Therefore in this case it will be subsidiary, but what type of answer given? I think you can understand by reading. To determine whether pharma limited can be continued to be classified as an associate on the transition to Ind AS, we'll have to determine whether angel limited controls pharma limited as defined under Ind AS 110. An investee controls an investee if and only if the investor has following element: power over investee, exposure or right to variable return, ability to use power, correct? Since angel limited does not have any majority voting right in pharma limited, we'll have to determine whether existing voting right of angel limited are sufficient to provide power over pharma limited elements. They have given power over investee. Angel limited along with subsidiary little angel limited does not have majority voting right in pharma limited. Therefore in order to determine whether angel group have power over pharma limited, we need to analyze whether angel group by virtue of its non-majority voting power have practical ability to unilaterally direct the relevant activities of pharma limited. In other words, we need to analyze whether angel group has de facto power over pharma limited. Following is the analysis. The public shareholding of pharma limited is 52% and none of the shareholders is holding material shareholding. Correct. The actual participation of individual public shareholders in the general meeting varies from 6% to 8%, means they are not able to what? Direct the relevant activities. Even in public shareholders who attend the meeting do not consult with each other to vote, means they have no what? Contractual agreement with other vote holders. Therefore, as per the guidance given in Ind AS 110, the public shareholders will not be able to outvote angel group. Based on the above mentioned analysis, we can conclude that angel group has de facto power over what? Pharma limited. Then exposure to or right to. Angel group has exposure to a variable return from its involvement in pharma limited by virtue of its equity stake. Correct? Then ability. So can I say angel group has the ability to use power in the capacity of principal and not as an agent to affect the amount of return from, means they are acting like a principal, they are not like acting like an agent. Condition satisfied, therefore it was, it means, but how to write down the answer? Write down the answer means you should have what? A good frame of knowledge about this control definition. Understood? This also you have understood. Any doubt?